Dear students, today we will learn about charge conservation in electrodynamics. Charge conservation states that the total charge in the universe is always a constant. So this statement of charge conservation is called global conservation of charge. Okay, so we can state this charge conservation as two types of statements. One of them is called global statement. The other one is called local statement. Okay, this global statement of charge conservation states that the total charge in the universe is a constant. Okay, total charge in the universe is a constant. Okay, this is called global conservation of charge. At the same time, we can state conservation of charge in the local form. Local form means if you consider a volume and consider the changing charge in this volume, this should be equal to the current flowing out through this volume, flowing out or in. Okay, this is called the local conservation of charge. Okay, so in this statement, in the local conservation of charge, the change in charge in a volume is equal to the current passing in or out through the surface, which is the boundary of the volume. Okay, which is the boundary of the volume. So we can state this conservation of charge in the two ways. The first one is called global conservation of charge because there we state that the total charge in the universe is a constant. Instead of this global statement, we will always use this local statement, because we know that if you consider a small volume and the change in charge in this volume, this change should be equal to the current flowing out or in through the boundary of this volume. That means the surface, closed surface, which is the boundary of the volume. Okay, this is called the local statement of conservation of charge. We already learned about continuity equation. We can derive continuity equation from Maxwell's equations. We already learned about Maxwell's equations. There are four laws which are known as Maxwell's equations. Okay, now think about the total charge capital Q enclosed in a volume. Okay, so you can write this Q of T, where this T is time. Q of T is the volume integral of the charge density. This charge density should be a function of position and time. Okay, and the elementary volume d dot. Okay, this is the total charge in a given volume V. Okay, now this local statement, local conservation of charge statement, tells us that the change in this charge dq by dt must be equal to the current passing out or in through the surface S. Okay, so this change should be equal to inverse of this surface integral of J dot dA. Okay, here this DA represents elementary aerial vector. This S represents the boundary of this volume, this closed surface S. Okay, then J represents the current density. So the current flowing out through this surface S or flowing in through this surface S should be equal to the change in charge, total charge in the volume. Okay, this is the local statement of this conservation of charge. Okay, now you can rewrite this equation using this one. Let it be one. This is equation one, and this local statement is equation two. Okay, now using this equation one, we can rewrite equation two. O by dou t of volume integral of rho of r t d. Okay, this is equivalent to dq by dt. Okay, and this should be equal to, in this LHS you can see that there is a closed surface integral j dot dA. Okay, where j is the current density and dA is the elementary aerial vector. Now we can apply Gauss divergence theorem to this LHS and convert this closed surface integral into volume integral. Okay, so you can write this equation as minus volume integral of divergence of the vector quantity. Here this is the current density. Okay, so del dot j d to. Okay, now we can merge these two equations together. So you get here the volume integral of dou rho by dou t, where rho is a function of position and time. Okay, dou rho by dou t plus del dot j d to equal to zero. Okay, so in this integrand you can see that this part represents the conservation, the local conservation of charge. That means the change in charge density dou rho by dou t should be equal to the divergence of the current density. Okay, divergence of the current density, this is called continuity equation. Okay, this is called continuity equation. And in this equation the parameters, here this rho represents charge density and j represent corresponding current. Okay, so this continuity equation means the conservation of charge in a given volume V. Okay, so this is called, this continuity equation is called local conservation of charge. Okay, so this is known as local conservation of charge. Local conservation of charge. Okay, Poynting's theorem is also known as work energy theorem in electrodynamics. Okay, so consider a collection of charges which forms a static charge distribution. So there should, we have to do some work against Coulomb repulsion to form a static charge distribution. Okay, so this work done to form a static charge distribution is WE is given by epsilon 0 by 2 volume integral of E square d to. Okay, here E represents the electric field due to the charges. Okay, similarly, suppose there is a we have to maintain a current through a circuit. In order to keep this current going through the circuit, there should be, we have to do some work against the back EMF. Okay, so the work done against the back EMF, now to maintain the current through the circuit is given by Wm equal to 1 by 2 mu 0 integral B square d tau. Okay, so in order to keep a static charge distribution, this much work we have to do. Similarly, in order to keep a current through a circuit, we have to do some work against the back EMF, that is this much. Here B represent the magnetic field produced by the current. Okay, so the total work done W, the total work done W is given by WE plus WM. Okay, that means this is equal to 1 by 2 volume integral of epsilon 0 E square plus B square by mu 0 E tau. Okay, this is the total work done to maintain a charge distribution and a current through the closed loop. Okay, now this is actually this part. This is represent the energy density, because we know that this work done represent the total energy. Since this total energy is a volume integral, the part inside this volume integral represent energy density. Okay, so let U represent the energy density, then U is given by epsilon 0 E square plus B square by mu 0 by 2. Okay, this is known as the energy density. Okay, this is the total work done or total energy in the electromagnetic field. Okay, now suppose that this charges and current produce electric field E and magnetic field B. Now some of the charges moves around. We want to know how much work has to be done by the electromagnetic forces. Okay, so the work done by the electromagnetic force, we know that the electromagnetic force is given by, okay, electromagnetic force is given by Q into E plus V cross B. Okay, E plus V cross B, this is the Lorentz force or force on the charges. Okay, now work done by this force, electromagnetic force, is given by F dot dl, where dl is the displacement produced on the charges. Okay, so if a particular time t there is a charge distribution which produce an electric field E and the corresponding magnetic field B. Okay, at the same time, if the charge moves around, then there is a change in the work done. The system wants to do work on these charges. Okay, and the work done by the electromagnetic force is given by this F dot dl. Okay, and we can substitute here. Okay, we can substitute here. F is given in this statement. So substituting here, Q into E plus V cross B dot dl. Instead of dl, we can write this as V dt. Okay, where V represent the velocity of the charge. Okay, instead of dl, we can write this as V dt. Okay, this is the work done by the electromagnetic force. Now the work done per unit time is given by dw by dt. Okay, work done per unit time is given by dw by dt, and this is equal to Q into E dot V. Okay, Q into E dot V. In this expression itself, you can see that in this second term, the second term is V cross B dot V. Okay, V cross B dot V is always zero because there are the same vector here again. Okay, so this is equal to Q into E dot V D. Okay, now the work done per unit time, work done per unit time is given by this expression. We know that Q into V represent, Q is the charge and V is the velocity. Q into V represent what? Before moving to this Q into V, you know that this Q into V represent current because charge into velocity. Okay, current, this represent current. So before moving to this writing in this form, you can write for Q using charge density. Okay, so this we can rewrite this equation as volume integral of rho of RT. Okay, where rho represents charge density, rho of RT, E dot V D. Okay, E dot V D. Here rho V represent current density. QV represent current and rho V represent current density. Okay, here rho V equal to current density J. Okay, rho V equal to current density J. So we can rewrite this work done per unit time by the electromagnetic force. dW by dt equal to volume integral of E dot J d tau. Okay, E dot J d tau. So here this represents E dot J represent energy density per unit time. Okay, or power per unit volume. Energy density per unit time or power per unit volume. E dot J represents energy density per unit time. Okay. Now, we know that using the fourth Maxwell's equation, we can rewrite this J. Okay. We know that this Ampere's law, del cross B, for electrodynamics, okay, for electrodynamics can be written as modified Ampere's law. Okay, that means del cross B equal to mu 0 J plus epsilon 0 dou E by dou T. Okay, this is modified Ampere's law for fourth Maxwell's equation. Okay, using this equation we can rewrite this J. Okay, that means from this equation you can see that J equal to, okay, this J equal to del cross B by mu 0 minus epsilon 0 dou E by dou T. Okay, so from this equation, this Maxwell's, Ampere's modified equation, you can rewrite for J like this. Yeah, we can substitute this J in this equation. Let it be this equation is equation 3. Okay, this is equation 3. And substituting this equation A in 3. Okay, substituting for J, you get here dW by dt equal to, okay, dW by dt equal to volume integral of 1 by mu 0 E dot del cross B, okay, E dot J. So first term is E dot del cross B, okay, and the second term is E dot dou E by dou T. Okay. So minus epsilon 0 E dot dou E by dou T. Equation 3 is takes a new form like this. If you are substituting for J. In this equation, you know that this J represents a current source. We want to rewrite this equation in terms of fields only. Okay, now you can see that here only, there are only field terms, electric field or magnetic field. Okay, so you can rewrite this equation in this form. Now, we have to simplify this equation once again. For simplifying this equation, we can make use of the identity del dot E cross B. Okay? Del dot E cross B can be written as B dot del cross E minus E dot del cross B. Okay, we can use this identity del dot E cross B equal to B dot del cross E minus E dot del cross B. Using this identity, you can replace E dot del cross B. Okay, so now this E dot del cross B takes the new form. So E dot del cross B, E dot del cross B takes the new form such that B dot del cross E, okay, B dot del cross E minus del dot E cross B. From this, you can write like this. E dot del cross B equal to B dot del cross E minus del dot E cross B. Okay. Now, we can substitute in equation 4 for this term. Substituting in equation 4, okay, you get the work done per unit time. Okay. Work done per unit time dW by dt equal to volume integral of 1 by mu 0 B dot del cross E minus del dot E cross B. Okay. Minus E dot del cross B, then minus epsilon 0 E dot dou E by dou T. Okay. Minus epsilon 0 E dot dou E by dou T. D. Okay. Now, the work done per unit time takes a new form like this. Okay. Now, we can rewrite these two equations again because you know that from curl equation for the third equation of Maxwell, that means del cross E equal to minus dou B by dou T. This is the Faraday's law. Okay. So, using this law, we can rewrite this term. Okay. B dot del cross E equal to B dot minus dou B by dou T. Okay. Minus dou B by dou T. And this is equal to, actually this is equal to minus 1 by 2 dou by dou T of B square. Okay. So, we can replace this term with dou by dou T of B square by 2. Okay. Similarly, here also this term. Okay.
epsilon 0 E dot dou E by dou t is takes the new form. Okay, this takes the new form. This is equal to epsilon 0 by 2 dou by dou t of E square. Okay, so instead of this term, you can write this in this equation. Okay, this is equation 5. Okay, equation 5. Now we can substitute this equation B and equation C in for this first and third term. Okay, for this first and third term. So now the work done per unit time, dW by dt equal to volume integral of B dot del cross E takes this new form. So we have here minus 1 by 2 B square by mu 0. Okay, B square by mu 0, and here again there is a minus sign, and this is equal to E square by dou t. Okay, here one right here minus of dou by dou t. Okay, minus of dou by dou t half B square by mu 0, and similarly this term you can write here epsilon 0 E square. Okay, epsilon 0 E square d tau. Okay, the first and third term, first and third term together you can write like this, minus volume integral of del dot E cross B d tau. Okay, but peculiarity of this equation, we already see that this represents the total energy in the fields. Okay, total work done, WE plus WM. Okay, so this term represents total energy density. Total energy density. This integrand is represent the total energy density. Okay, so in terms of U, we can rewrite again this equation. And now dW by dt equal to volume integral of minus dou u by dou t d tau minus volume integral of del dot E cross B d tau. Okay? Okay, now we can define, we can rewrite this second term in terms of the closed surface integral. Okay, so again we can write here this negative minus volume integral dou u by dou t d tau minus closed surface integral. This closed surface is the boundary of the volume V. E cross B dot dA by mu 0. Okay. Now, here this term is called Poynting's vector. Okay. So, E cross B by mu 0 is called vector S. This is known as Poynting's vector. Energy per unit time per unit area transported by the field. Okay, Poynting's vector represents energy per unit time per unit area transported by the fields. Okay, and now we can rewrite this work energy theorem in terms of Poynting's vector dW by dt equal to minus volume integral of dou u by dou t dTo minus surface integral of Poynting's vector dot dA. Okay, this is known as work energy theorem in electrodynamics or Poynting's theorem. Okay, this is known as work energy theorem in electrodynamics or Poynting's theorem. This theorem, its physical meaning is actually the conservation of energy in electrodynamics or electromagnetic fields. Okay, so the change work done per unit time is equal to the decreasing energy in a given volume, less the energy transported by the fields. Okay, energy transported out or in through the surface S by the fields. This is the Poynting's theorem or the energy conservation for electrodynamics. Okay, so in this lecture we learned about charge conservation and Poynting's theorem. The case of charge conservation, we found that we can state conservation of charge in two ways. One is called global conservation law, where we state that the total charge in the universe is a constant. Here, the Poynting's theorem represents the work energy theorem in electrodynamics, and it states that the work done per unit time is always equal to the decreasing energy density in a given volume less to the energy transported by the fields out of this volume. So, thank you.